Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at how to use iTunes 11 to organize the apps on your iPhone and iPad. So if you sync your Mac and your iOS device, then you'll have your apps in both places. Matter of fact, you may have a lot more on your Mac because you're storing them all there and you only have a selection of them on your iOS device. Either way, when you go into iTunes, you could go and select apps to view your library of apps. And these are all the apps that you have stored on your Mac in iTunes. Now, in icon view, it's only somewhat useful, though it should be in alphabetical order, and you can kind of scroll through them and see what apps you've got. And if there's some old apps here you don't want anymore, you can select it and hit the delete key to delete them. But it's much more useful if you actually go to the list view. In the list view, you can sort by clicking on the tops here, the top of each column. Click twice and it will sort in reverse. So for instance, if you wanted to sort by size, you can sort here and see what your largest apps are. So perhaps if you have some large apps and it's a game you're not playing any longer, you can select it and delete it, clearing off space from the iTunes library on your Mac. You can also sort in other ways, for instance by date added or purchase date. That way you could go back and or reverse the sort here and see which apps you downloaded the longest time ago, and that way perhaps you can also see some more that you can get rid of. So by sorting here in the list view and selecting and then deleting apps, you can better maintain your library of apps. Now remember, just because you delete it here doesn't mean you can't get it again. Once you've purchased an app, you can always re-download it, as long as the app's still available, of course. So if there's an app that you think, well, I don't need it right now, but in the future I may want to play that game again, well, as long as the game's still available in the App Store, you can go back and instead of purchasing it, it'll just have a download link. Now what about on your device? Well, in iTunes here, we can click here and see that I've got three devices. So let's jump to my iPad as an example. So now I've got some various tabs at the top, and you want to click Apps, of course, to view your apps. On the left you'll see a list of all the apps in your iTunes library, and on the right you'll see each screen of your device. So you can go through it, and this is kind of a mock-up of the screen that you would normally see if you were looking at this case at my iPad. So if an app hasn't been installed over here, it's not presently there, I can simply click this button here to install it. If it's already installed, it'll say Remove, and I can click this button to remove it. Now there's no other view here, so you have this kind of icon list view, but you can search. So for instance, you can quickly search and put a term in there and it will sort of narrow down what you've got. So you can pretty quickly get to an app and see if it's installed or not and take action. Also, another cool thing you could do is if you don't know where the app is on your device, say you've lost it, say it's in some subfolder, you can't seem to find it, you can click here and double click and it will actually jump to that app. So here it's jumped to screen 3 and inside the subfolder, and it shows me where that app is. So this is a handy way to be able to find that app icon that you can never seem to remember where it is you put on your device. You can also, of course, use these screens over here to organize your apps, which may be a little easier if you have a lot of apps. So for instance, you can click and rearrange apps, move them to different screens just by dragging down here to the bottom and it will move it. You can, of course, delete apps that are not the pre-installed apps. Notice that, of course, apps like Messages and Calendar and all cannot be deleted. You roll over them. But apps that you have installed, like Twitter and Podcast, you can delete from the device. They're still in your library, so you can just reinstall them. But it's a quick way to kind of maintain what's on your device by using iTunes on your Mac or PC. Also, a few other things I want to point out here. There's the all-important checkbox here called Automatically Install New Apps right under this list. So this is, if it's checked, this may explain why, if you don't like this feature, that when you download an app, say, to your iPhone and then you sync your iPad to your Mac, you may notice that that app automatically comes over. This is particularly tricky if you have, say, one computer and you're maintaining several different devices, maybe even across family members, and say your kid downloads an app to their device and then you find you get that app eventually on your device. Well, this is the setting here that will do that through the syncing process. Also here, of course, notice at the bottom this meter here that tells you what is on your device. So for instance, I can see I have a lot of apps on this device. I've got some videos. And everybody always asks me about other. Well, what other is it's data. So various apps have data. So it might be as simple as, say, a game having the saved game state, and maybe something like Pages having your Pages documents, or Keynote having Keynote documents. Other apps may store tons of stuff in there. For instance, mapping and tracking apps may store lots of different maps on them. So, you know, for instance, on my Audible app for audiobooks, we'll put a lot in other if I store a lot of audiobooks in there. So that's exactly what other is. It's basically your data being used by the different apps. So with iOS 6, it's not necessary at all for you to maintain your iOS device by syncing it with your Mac. But it can be very useful because you can use it to organize not only things like your music and your videos, but also your apps through using these tools. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.